Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD, bodybuilder, back with another video. Today we're going to be talking about how much protein you need. This is definitely something I wondered a lot about when I first got into bodybuilding, and it's still probably one of the most common questions I get asked today. So brief outline, first we're going to talk about what the science says and give you my recommendation. After that, we'll talk about some caveats of my recommendation, and then go over some of the pros and cons of a high protein diet. Now you may have heard of the popular 1 gram per pound bodybuilding rule. That is, you need to consume a minimum of 1 gram per pound of your body weight per day in order to optimize muscle growth. I'm gonna start right off by debunking that rule, as there have been multiple studies showing that there's no benefit for consuming more than 0.82 grams per pound of body weight in protein per day. At this point, the evidence behind the 0.82 grams per pound per day minimum is actually pretty strong. So if you're consuming that amount of protein per day, you're safe in terms of maximizing muscle growth. If you want to dig deeper into the studies in full detail, I'll link you in the show notes below. Now, my personal recommendation for protein intake is between 0.82 and 1.0 grams per pound per day. That's 1.8 to 2.2 grams per kilo. Now, I would suggest leaning towards the higher end of this range when you're cutting, and we'll talk about why in a second. Now, you'll notice that my range actually includes the 1 gram per pound rule. And while I just said that I'm debunking this rule, I'll also say that it's not a bad thing. And I think the power behind the 1 gram per pound rule is simplicity. It's really easy for people to visualize the 1 gram per pound of body weight in their head. And it doesn't hurt them to be slightly over our minimum cutoff based on the scientific literature. Now, why do I suggest a higher protein intake when you're cutting? This is actually quite hotly debated in the scientific community right now. Now, if you're conducting a fat loss phase, your goal is to lose fat and keep your muscle or even build muscle. Now, this comes to a balance between protein breakdown and protein synthesis in your body. It makes sense that if synthesis is greater than breakdown, you'll build muscle. Now, it has been suggested that protein breakdown increases when you're in an energy deficit, and or that protein synthesis might decrease. Now, in order to make up for these changes, it might be helpful to increase your protein intake slightly when you're dieting. Now, at this point, there's not enough evidence to say for sure that you need to increase your protein in a caloric deficit, but I do include it in my personal recommendation of moving up towards around 1 gram per pound when you're cutting. Now, I'm going to go over a caveat to these recommendations, and that is if you are a high body fat percentage. Now, if your body fat percentage is relatively high, something like over 20%, it doesn't make sense to estimate your protein based on your body weight, because your numbers are going to be more than what you actually need. In this case, you should be estimating your lean body mass in order to figure out your protein intake. Or you can use a rule of thumb of estimating your protein intake based on your height in centimeters, which I learned from Eric Helms. So say you're 170 centimeters tall, you might start at 170 grams of protein per day as your minimum intake. Lastly, I'd like to talk a little bit about the pros and cons of a high protein diet. By high protein, I mean going significantly higher than the 0.82 grams per pound minimum cutoff. First of all, I'll mention that going slightly above 1 gram per pound per day isn't going to harm your health. This doesn't apply to people who have pre-existing kidney disease, and in that case, you should talk to your doctor first. Now, in terms of the pros of a high protein diet, a lot of people find that protein sources keep them full for longer. And it has actually been shown in a couple studies that a higher protein intake was correlated to better satiety during a weight loss phase. Second of all, just personal preference. So if you enjoy eating protein sources, I think it's great to accommodate that because it'll help with satisfaction and your adherence to your diet. Now, to go over a few cons of a high protein diet. Protein sources generally are more expensive than carb and fat options. Second of all, high protein food sources are relatively more inconvenient to obtain. Depending on how strictly you're tracking your macros, it's relatively easier to walk into a convenience store or restaurant and choose meal options that are based more on carbohydrates and fats. Lastly, a problem of increasing your protein intake to very high numbers is that it displaces your other macros. This isn't so much of a problem when you're bulking, but when you're cutting, your total number of calories is very limited, and carbohydrate intake actually becomes very important, mainly because carbohydrates are the main energy source our body uses for training. Keeping your training stimulus optimal is really important in a cut in order to maintain or build more muscle. So I wouldn't suggest driving your protein sky high if you perform better in the gym with more carbohydrates instead. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, make sure you like the video and leave me a comment. This will help me grow the channel so we can reach more people. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you next time.